Our Digi Descendant are not able to catch a break. Like seriously, first it was Icemon, then just after that it was Orochimon and now Nidhoggmon. But this episode was pretty amazing and I really loved a lot of things and a lot of plot points that they were bringing forward. Now hello and welcome to UnderWYZ, my name is Soham and today we are going to talk about Digimon Adventure 2020 series reboot episode number 18. Now if you're new here then please consider subscribing to the channel since I do weekly Digimon related content. We're also trying to hit 5,000 subscribers by the end of 2020, so like and sub would be massively appreciated. With that being said, let's begin the video. Now, our heroes are just recovering from the last fight with Orochimon when there is a mysterious countdown that is engulfing both the real world as well as the digital world. Things are not at all looking good in the real world as well. This was a very interesting thing. I really liked the interaction here because of the series taking place in the modern world, so everyone has smartphones. Now these smartphones, I mean all of these digital gadgets, they are showing this mysterious countdown, and not only that, these smartphones are getting so hot that people are compelled to throw them down. I mean, this was a really nice foreshadowing of the things that are about to come, because Nidhoggmon was actually taking in the data from the real world. It was amassing data in the form of these smartphones and all the digital devices. I really like this incorporation in the story plot because it really shows that we are currently in the modern age where technology, like science and technology, has really taken over and it's everywhere. Human life is surrounded by technology. So this was a pretty interesting plot line. Like usually we always get missiles and sort of stuff like that, but this was really nice in my opinion. Moreover, yeah, obviously we had some elements and plot points from Digimon R-War games as well as some other references and nods to Digimon Tamers in the form of Nidhoggmon, which was basically looking like an Eldritch Abomination in the form of the D-Reaper from Tamers. But this guy, this mega level Digimon, was an absolute behemoth. He was towering huge. It was so big, like I really enjoyed the visuals of this episode. But there are obviously some things which I didn't like as well. I especially didn't like how only Taichi and Yamato just got up. I mean, yeah, fine, Koshiro was conveying the information and everything to all these guys and all as to what exactly was going on between the real world as well as the digital world. But I really didn't like the fact that Sora and others didn't even stand up. Like, at least they should have tried. Like, I'm not saying that they needed to go to the ultimate level to, you know, try and help them out, but at least some sort of a fight would have been made much more sense in my opinion. I understand that they were all exhausted after the previous fight and Taichi and Yamato were just pushing forward because of the sheer willpower, because they needed to save their siblings. I understand that plot point and that is conveyed to us very well in the form of both Hikari as well as TK. The feather plot point is coming up again and again, and let's be real at this point, the feather is definitely linked to the formation of Omegamon, because that's what exactly happens here. Taichi and Yamato charge forward along with Agumon and Gabumon, and they are just trying their level best to take down this Digimon, and all of this is because of the sheer willpower to save everyone, save Tokyo and save their siblings. That's when we get the feather scene and that's when Omegamon finally appears. This was awesome, but for some reason I don't know why they chose not to have extreme battle in this particular episode. It was sort of a different episode, not gonna lie, because in other episodes whenever we get a anime Digimon, we immediately start the fighting, but here there was a lot of foreshadowing and information that is given and then the fight happened. This was not a direct fight, okay, just blast fight, that sort of thing didn't happen here. This was a nice change of pace, if you could call it like that. Now obviously at the end, Omegamon was able to defeat this Nidhoggmon and just sliced him in half, but before that there is something very important or something very intriguing that happens. What happens is that Hikari as well as TK are in the real world and they are seeing these smartphones lying around everywhere, like the data is being sucked in and everything. And it's not just them, it's even the other children who are also watching this in amazement as well as horror as to what exactly is going on. I think this is going to play a plot point later on in the series, at least later on towards the end of the series. And I think this is a reference to Digimon Cross Wars as well. Because if you remember, Shoutmon X7, that final Digivolution which was able to defeat Bagramon, that thing was seen by a lot of kids and that is what inspired them to become the hunters in the very first place. So will this be a motivation point? Will we get something like that? Something along the way? I'm not 100% sure, but I think that's something gonna happen. Because we already see TK and Hikari seeing their brothers in the battle and This was the thing, this was the motivation that they needed to finish off Nidhoggmon. This was done in a very nice manner. I really liked the color palette as well as the animation techniques that were involved here. And with that, we finally get the end of Nidhoggmon. The battle was not something extreme. It was not an extreme battle that happened here. It was a fairly normal battle, but the mystery element of this episode was the major thing involved here. I really like the mystery and the build up towards this episode and how everything happened here. But the most important fact is that this is not over. Just after the defeat of Nidhoggmon, something very interesting happens. A sort of a wormhole opens up and that sucks in all the other Digidestined barring Taichi and Yamato. So all the rest of them have been transported to a separate location, and we also get to see a different Digimon in a baby level or some other level. And I don't exactly remember which Digimon this is, I'm very sorry. If anyone knows what Digimon this is exactly, then please write it in the comment section below. Personally, I feel like this is Lucimon, or rather the baby stage of Lucimon. And if that's actually happening, if Lucimon is actually coming back, then that's going to be a pretty interesting choice for this season. I'm not 100% sure, so if any one of you know which Digimon this was being referred here with that one eye sort of thing, then that would be really awesome. And in the very end, we also get to see Devimon. And not only that, that one-eyed Digimon actually talked to Devimon for a bit, and then Devimon showed up to Taichi and Yamato in the form of a dust balloon sort of a thing, and he tried to attack them. And yeah, that's the episode. That's pretty much the entire episode. I really liked the conflict and the mystery element of this episode, and this was a nice change of pace in my opinion. We still don't know a lot of things, like how exactly Omnimon appeared, or how exactly Hikari and Tiki are getting this power up from the feather. I'm pretty sure all of this is because of the Holy Digimon, because let's be real, Angemon and Angewomon are appearing very soon in the series. So let's see how all of this ties out eventually to the plot, and next week we are going to see finally Liomon once again. Please don't die, Liomon, please don't die, I can't see you die once again. So that's pretty much all in this episode. Thank you so much for watching. Please mention your thoughts in the comment section below. So that's it for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like it. Share it with your friends and subscribe to the channel for more. This is WonderYZ, and I'll see you soon in the next video.